Hi everyone and Happy New Year. 2021 is just gonna be great. Well, let's recap. How did I do last year on the various food delivery apps and Rideshare? So stick around and we'll get right into it. Hi everyone, my name is Russ and welcome back to the channel. On my channel, I give you tips on how to improve your earnings and ratings for food delivery companies. It's something that I do part-time and I enjoy it quite a bit. So let's get right into it. But wait, before we can get into 2020, let's recap into 2019. So in 2019, I mostly did rideshare. For my rides, I had 965. Food deliveries, 125. That totals 1,090. Rideshare was 89% of the money that I made on the different apps. And then obviously food delivery was 11%. I drove a total of 25,000 miles in 2019. That's a lot. And I earned $12,000. Gas was $3,120 or 20% of my income. So that was quite a bit for gas. After all the expenses that I had, including some costly repairs, I profited $4,100 for the entire year. At the end of this video, I'll link the video that I recap my 2019 earnings so you can watch that. In that video, I also give you some tips on is rideshare worth it or not. So do check it out later. Oh, yes. We're ready right to move into 2020. Check this out. Just in time as well. Now, on to 2020. In 2020, I had a total of 237 rides for rideshare. Keep in mind, this was January through mid-March until the coronavirus stopped all that. For food deliveries, I totaled 961, and that totals 1,198. That's quite a bit. Rideshare was 20% of my workload, and food deliveries was 80%. So obviously, most of it was food. I drove a total of 13,000 miles, and I earned $11,000. So let's symbolize that with some money. Of my $11,000, which you can see here, $100 bills, I've got 11 of them. $11,000. So gas was $2,200, so that would be $2,000 gone, and that was 20% of my income. Gas prices were a little cheaper this year than they were last year, so I know that helped as well. And then I had $2,000 in repairs that were not very fun, but my car should be very reliable now, so I'm grateful. And then $1,000 was regular maintenance, and that includes oil changes, air filters, car washes, etc. That left me with $6,000. That is so cool, much better than last year. 2020 was awesome, and I'm so happy that I made $6,100 profit. Yes! Another delivery. All right, so what are the takeaways from what I learned for this year and comparing it to last year? Well, I earned $2,000 more, but I drove 12,000 miles less. That is huge. Think about it. And the second point, is rideshare worth it? Well, you know what? That depends. Again, check out that video at the end, and it'll recap my key learnings from when I did rideshare in 2019. Another thing is, pay attention to your dollars per mile, not just the dollars per hour. The dollars per hour are easy. Yeah, I wanna earn 20 bucks, 30 bucks an hour. But if I'm running up hundreds of miles on my car, then it may not be worth it. So try to only accept food deliveries that are gonna give you at least a dollar per mile or more. Obviously, shorter distance for the higher pay is the best thing. Another thing to consider would be the different shopping apps where you do Instacart or the food deliveries where you go in and shop. Wear and tear on your body is good for you. That's called exercise. Wear and tear on your car is depreciation and it's running your car into the ground. So no matter what, please save money for a new car. Keep track of everything, all your expenses, and use a tax professional. You can either do that standard deduction of the mileage, you know, I think it's 56, 57 cents, or you can itemize and do a percentage, keeping track of all your miles, personal and business. So track everything, I do. But again, I'm not a tax professional. I thank you so much for watching this. I hope that you also can learn from these key learnings. And please share in the comments below, what are you gonna do as a side hustle in 2021 to make some extra money? All right, take care, stay safe, and I'll see you later. Bye.